G'day friends and welcome to another one of my videos. Now today we're talking about the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K shooting resolutions. 4K DCI, Ultra HD, HD Anamorphic. What in heaven's name does all this mean? So if you want to decipher and find out when to use these different formats, well then stick around. And welcome back. Now, if you've seen some of my videos before, you'll probably realize that I'm a bit of a novice or a noob in the content creation scene. Now, every time I buy a piece of equipment, I find it that it's the best learning opportunity. And I like to learn, and I'm sure so do you. So if you like this content and you find it useful, don't forget to subscribe. Now back to the video. The Blackmagic Design Pocket Cinema Cameras are unique in the sense they help anyone that wants to learn video creation in a very simple and affordable way. But its simplicity doesn't mean sacrificing creativity. With this in mind, the amazing people at Blackmagic Design have given us enough technology to create some wonderful visuals without having to purchase expensive camera equipment. But why do we have a variety of 4K and HD shooting modes? Let's start at the highest resolution and work our way down to see if we can figure out why they're there. The first shooting mode is 4K DCI, which is a resolution of 4096 by 2160 pixels, and you can record up to 60 frames per second. Now, DCI stands for Digital Cinema Initiatives and is the standard of a consortium of major motion picture companies. The next resolution is 4096 by 1720, which is 4K, but it's in a 2.4:1 ratio, which closely resembles the CinemaScope crop, and it's still considered within the DCI specifications. In the Pocket Cinema Camera, this resolution will give you the ability to record up to 75 frames per second. And this happens to be my favorite look, and hopefully I'll be able to create more videos in this format in the future. I would use this shooting format to give your videos that cinematic look. You do lose that on a 16:9 screen because you can see the black bars on top and the bottom, but if you're lucky enough to have an ultra wide monitor, normally you can fit that whole footage right on that screen and it looks quite impressive. Ultra HD or 3840 by 2160 is the 16:9 ratio, which we're all familiar with because it's what modern TVs and monitors use as an aspect ratio, and that will fill up all the screen when you're recording this mode. This standard was agreed upon by the SMPTE, which stands for the Society of Motion Picture and Television Engineers. This society's members include amazing individuals such as James Cameron, George Lucas, and Walt Disney, to mention a few. And in comparison with 4K DCI, you start seeing the very slight differences where you're getting less pixels, and this is represented by those bands on either side of your screen. The basic distinctions between 4K DCI and Ultra HD are, I guess, a bridge between the old traditional way of making movies for the big screen and the new modern mediums such as your television screens and streaming media online. The next resolution is the one that I'm most excited to learn about in videos in the future, which is 2.8K or Anamorphic or 2880 by 2160. There are plenty of videos on YouTube that praise its quality and its beautiful effects on light. As you can see, the images captured with this format without using the proper lens renders it unusable, but I can't wait to get my hands on one of these lenses in the future so I can try it out myself. The second last resolution offered by the Pocket Cinema Camera is 2K or 2.6K to be exact, 2688 by 1512 pixels. It also complies with a 16:9 ratio. And if you're someone that wants to achieve a better resolution than 1080p and also wants to capture a high frame rate for slow motion, then this resolution will allow you to capture up to 120 frames per second. Because of the higher pixel rate, this particular format lends itself well to being able to stabilize in post-production because it has that innate cropping that happens when you digitally stabilize. So you can still bring it down to 1080, but you'll get more pixels in the screen and a nice and steady image. Last of all, Blackmagic managed to fit the 1920 by 1080 or HD format with a frame rate of up to 120 frames per second. Now, this format probably is the one that suffers the most with a heavy crop and a lack of full utilization of the sensor. The quality is not great, but one redeeming consideration though is that because of the lower resolution, it doesn't require an expensive CFast card or SSD drive to capture the footage. You can use an SD card, which I guess is a benefit. In summary, what I've discovered is that if you want to shoot in 4K and want to display on a TV or monitor and utilize the full screen, you cannot go past the 16:9 aspect ratios. That's the Ultra HD 3840 by 2160 or the 2.6K 2688 by 1512. Using the latter will allow you to get decent quality and higher frame rates if you want to shoot a bit of slow-mo. If you're looking for the sexier cinematic look, then you can't go past the 4K widescreen or 4096 by 1720. This format will still allow you to capture a decent 75 frames per second if required. But if your goal is high quality, but you don't need to exceed 60 frames per second, and you have very fast media to record on, then the 4K DCI is your best bet. Also, don't forget to use the framing guides on the Pocket Cinema Camera if you want to use the full sensor, but are planning to either crop into a cinematic mode in the future. That way you can get all your pixels and you may be able to do a bit of stabilization without losing too much of that quality. So that's it. So hopefully this brief video gave you a good understanding on the Blackmagic Pocket Cinema Camera 4K shooting modes and when they can be used for what format. If you like this content, don't forget to subscribe. Stay healthy, stay safe, and until the next video, ciao for now.